Hi everyone, welcome to the third part of the Learning Scriptcase from Scratch course. My name is Nate Carpenter, I'm the instructor leading this course. So today we're starting with the development environment, specifically the interface, the user interface of this. So we're going to get a little bit more familiar with getting around in Scriptcase. So this is the third part, the development environment, and there's about four videos in this section of the course. So this is the first one here. So you've got the database set up, it's all configured, it's all ready to go, the backend is ready, but you're not quite ready to start developing yet. There's still a lot of options in the development environment that you're not familiar with. So let's go ahead and get familiar with that user interface a little bit more. So let's go over to the Scriptcase and see all the options that we have. Okay, so here we are in the Scriptcase development environment, and there's kind of three main areas. First, you have this blue menu across the top. Then you have a kind of a quick actions toolbar right here, and we can customize that. And then you have a main area here where you have your applications. You have folders over here. You can organize your applications in the folders. You can delete folders. You can rename folders. And then once we create applications, they're going to appear down there. Let's get started with the blue menu, the project menu here. So you've seen some of these. You can create a project, close a project, open a project. You can run it. You can set some default values for that project. You can increment versions or version control. You can generate source code, deploy the project, delete it, all those different options here. There's also some reports. You can see all the applications and what different developers have done. You can show diagrams of all the applications, and you can search within the project. Then databases. We've seen all this before in the last videos. So creating databases, editing databases, importing some data. And then applications. So once we have applications created, we can create them with the new ones or restore or batch applications. Then we can export or import applications. We can see what is in the session. We can see the source code. We can save them, etc. Then tools. We have APIs. So there's lots of different APIs that Scriptcase supports. And then we have hotkey templates to control keystrokes. And we have code snippets, so little bits of code that we can bring in. We have a data dictionary. We have another video for that. Express edit and help case for some help links there. You can define those. We have external libraries for JavaScript and HTML, and internal libraries with some PHP. And then we have some task management, so to-do lists, messages, etc. Then layout, we have CSS applications. So those are our themes. We've seen some of those, and we can add some more there. We can also create custom themes. So here's our theme, and we could copy that, or we could create a new theme in Scriptcase like so. And then we have some buttons there, control buttons, some templates for HTML templates there. Menus, CSS menus, icons, images, chart themes, we'll look at charts later, and HTML templates as well. Then we have locales, so that's if we have multiple languages or multiple different regional settings for currency display, date display, etc. Then we have modules, so we have the security module and the logging module, so we're going to have a separate video for those, and then options here, and we're going to look at those in the next video, but we can control the toolbar. And that's our next option here, this quick actions toolbar. So this is the default layout, but we can add different buttons on here. So these project ones are the green buttons here, and the ones that are grayed out are already on the screen, and then we could click to add more. So the same with database, application, tools, layout, etc., all across the top of that quick action toolbar can be controlled there. And then we have hotkeys, and we can change our password there. And then help, we can get some web help, technical support, some diagnosis if we're getting help and we need to see some statistics on our system, and then we can update or check our version, and then register our system as well, which we've already seen. So let's go back to home here, and then by going back to home, we can go right back to our home screen here. Let me go over, and that's going to load our home applications area here. So wait for that to load. So there it is. And then, as you can see, we've already seen our main applications area. So this is the toolbar. So some of those other options that we've seen on those menus there are on here as quick actions. So new applications, and then we can save our applications once it's created. We can generate the source code for that, and then we can run it, and then we can also deploy it. We have our data dictionary, which we're going to have another video for, and the application language as well, if we have multiple applications, multiple languages, and then our help link as well. And as you can see here, we can see versions about information about our project, and then we can see information about our development environment too, the licensing, etc. And we can go to our My Scriptcase area as well. And here we have some notifications. So Scriptcase might send a notification about a new version or something, and it will appear there. And then we can full screen the development environment with that button there too. So then we just have our application area, which we've already seen. So that is the main part of the development environment in Scriptcase.